Well, we found out that heart radio broadcast from even further away than I said. I thought they came from Bristol, but after various Google searches, I found out they came from St. Thomas. That's not true. And JD found out they came from London, which is really local to Exeter.
But it's very confusing, because now that they've got something here, postal address is in Exeter Business Park. But I don't know. I have to do a bit more research on that one. Perhaps if I ring the studio and say, "Oi, where are you?"
But I think just going back, the general point is how radio works, because it's made up of lots of bits and pieces which come together in a studio.
Yes, but not necessarily always in the studio.
Well, where
I could go to the local hot drink place and broadcast from there.
Oh, right.
You see, quite easy, because we've got the technology now to do that.
Me and Will have done that.
Yes.
Yes, you've done that up in your London trip.
No, we've done that many years ago. We broadcast on the Key.
Yes. Yeah. Yes, we did. We went to the Key.
Was that the front door key or the back door key?
No, the key down by the canal.
Oh, right.
And yes, well, we through the miracle of a mobile phone.
Yes,
yeah. We found the studio.
Yeah. Yes,
We did.
Well, you can now make your little studio up of your microphone and your mixer,
yes,
and plug it into, like you said, like your phone.
Right,
and there you go. You've got an OB system, outside broadcasting
system.
System.
Yes. Yeah. So this idea, going back to where this started, the idea that heart radio is a model for a globally transformed technological integrated resource.
That's a long word phrase for that.
We'll have to ask the Exeter University Business School
I'll just get the dictionary out.
Usually here on radio we try and explain what they're talking about, but obviously we could do it the other way around.
Okay.
Exeter, Hard FM, London, Hard FM, Hertfordshire, whatever. And if you're listening to Hard FM in one of those regional stations, you get local weather, local DJs, local advertising, local traffic, local gossip, local stuff for local people. Brilliant. Except, of course, Hard FM isn't daft enough to also run 45 local back-end offices with each of their finance systems and recruitment and CRMs, and you get the picture, right? It's all centralised in some tin shed in, who cares? I don't care as a listener to Hard FM. And yet Hard FM is able to deliver to me local services tailored to my local needs. Now, that's a simplified solution, but the idea is, where there is no public value in differentiation, in producing different stuff, in other words, is it really important that my local hospital in Exeter has a different customer relationship management system or patient administration system?
But could radio work in this manner? Could there be shared resources somewhere up in the cloud?
Well, with the technologies there, we could probably share and talk to somebody on another radio station this morning.
Yes.
Quite easily. And get to know where they are, what they do, and that sort of thing. So it actually advertises them.
Right. We did. We talked to Access All Aerials, our sponsor.
That's true.
Yes.
Oh, they're our sponsor. Chris, you should say some more about them.
Yeah.
If they're our sponsor.
Okay.
What is this Access All Aerials?
Access All Aerials is another community radio station who sponsor our show, which just means our show goes out on their radio station, courtesy of me uploading it and sending it to Craig. But I was talking about when Carl was Craig. they could get very confusing. Yeah. And I rang in and spoke to Carl.
Right.
And all the people at Seal Hay.
The radio station now comes underneath a charity called CEDA, which is based at the Clare Mill Trust. Yes.
Yes.
Yeah, and it's now, they're doing very well, because I've been reading all about them on the local rags of different things. So they're doing quite well now. I've donated my programmes because I could see that they could do with, you know, some spirit behind them as in the beginning. So I gave them all my programmes. So you'll hear me on there as well.
So that is, just to be clear, that is the 80s voguing show.
Yes.
And it comes on a Friday evening.
Fridays, yeah. Yeah, it's always been Fridays. It will always be Fridays. And if it changes, they have to pay me.
Okay. That's a generous offer.
Yeah, it's a generous offer. That was the offer.
So they have to pay you in coffee, I guess.
Yes, because that's what you're doing. You see, you're paying me in coffees.
Okay.
So therefore, you know, I must have a wage.
Would it be easier if the listener could bypass the studio and the brand names of the radio stations and everything?
Yeah.
And just mumble into their phone what sort of music they would like. And
I was mumbling into my phone. Come on, that's
and the phone will just go and get it, and a bit of time wasting chat as well.
Well, it'd be nice if we find an app which actually you can do that. You can say, I fancy listening to rock and roll, and then up will come radio stations with rock and roll in it and programs right then. So you don't have to sit there.
So the radio stations are still there.
Yeah.
But the listener can select. Chris is
waving.
You don't have to wave at us. You've got the faders, Chris.
What's your point here?
I think the listener really want to listen to some good Charlotte. So here it is.